My name is M. Dhaneshekaran and welcome to this database lessons video series. In this video, let us take a look at Oracle Database User Architecture. Remember the flight example? Let us visit this to learn about Oracle. Now, let me call this plane as plane. See how creative I am. And technically, I can say all the parts of the plane belongs to the plane. I can refer its left wing as plane.leftwing, right wing as plane.rightwing, rudder as plane.rudder. Like that, I can refer its other parts too. It's kind of like the pattern owner.objectName. Important thing is, who is the owner? Plane is the owner. Now, let us see who has the rights to use those objects. I mean, the controls. The pilot has the rights. The pilot can use those objects. The pilot can take off the plane, fly the plane, and land the plane. The pilot is the primary authority of that plane. Now, the pilot doesn't need to do all the administrative functions on a plane. There are flight attendants who could do some of those administrative functions. They can control the overhead compartments, interior light switches, attend to the passengers' need, etc. So, they are next to the pilot in terms of authority. And remember, they still operate on the objects owned by the plane. And then there are passengers. They bring their own belongings and each own rights on their belongings. Let's say Jack is a passenger and he brought a laptop and a carry-in baggage. How do we refer those? We can refer those as Jack.laptop and Jack.baggage. And then passenger Jill has brought a tablet computer and a carry-in baggage. How do we refer her belongings? We can refer those as Jill.tablet and Jill.baggage. Passenger Mickey did not bring anything. Now, let us compare this to the world of Oracle Database. Plane is owner of all the important objects that are needed for the plane to function. Like that, there is a user inside of every Oracle database called Sys. This user owns all the Oracle-related internal objects. Then, who is the pilot? Remember, pilot is not the name of a person, right? It's a privilege. We may have a pilot for today's flight, and there will be another one coming in as the pilot for tomorrow's flying of the same plane. So, pilot is a privilege. The equivalent of it in Oracle database is SysDBA privilege. Any user who has been granted with SysDBA privilege can start and stop the database. Generally, the senior members of the database administrator's team in a company will have SysDBA privileges. Then, the database administrator team may have junior members who would do the regular database administration tasks. They may not have privileges to the internal objects like SysDBAs, but still can help with regular database administration tasks. These people are like the flight attendants. Then there will be regular database users who use the database. They are like the passengers. And like the passengers, Jack and Jill, some can own their own objects such as tables, indexes, etc. And like Mickey, some will not own any objects at all. The users who own objects are called as schemas, while the users who don't own anything are called as just users. I simplified the architecture so that it will be easy for you to understand if you are a beginner. Of course, as with every simplification, there will be some differences in the analogy and the real product. For example, in the analogy, plane is a machine and not a person. If we strictly compare it to the sys user in database, then sys should be a rigid entity. However, sys is also a database user. It's very common for a database administrator in a company to log in as the user sys with the privilege sysdba. However, I hope you are able to understand the user architecture. Thank you for watching this video.